Sometimes, David, when we move the fastest, we're at the stillness. And so in the sense that we're not rushing into anything here. We're already here. We're alive. We're living on this planet. We can all see what's going on through global eyes. We've got 196 different nations, all with their laws and regulations and borders to maintain, and the whole world is at war, competing with one another for survival, and we're destroying the planet the way we're living on it. It's a false order we're in, under misguided nation leaders. Like, it's one world. We're not divided, except in our minds. We're kept separate. And in our situations, we're living in conditions which prevent us from actually thinking clearly, freely, about one world and the way we're living on it. These are tough times. We're in an emergency. This is a crisis. The world needs to change the structure we're living under. What do you have to say to that?
Patience. And you're probably insane, because you probably think free will is real. And there's no saving the world while ignoring that fact.
But whoever created this world at one time exercised the will that this become. So somewhere there was a free will, the creation, because we're here.
No. You're just having a problem with beginninglessness.
Yeah, how can the brain contemplate beginninglessness?
The only
there's always a relative.
The only way to contemplate it is to see the reality that you are God, and that you have no beginning. And you look back physically to your experiences till you're a kid, and then to your parents, and then you see what made your parents, and then you see what made them, and them, and them, and them, and then you see that it doesn't stop ever. Yeah.
Yeah, but how would you relate that to the world that you're living in?
By at least rather being dead than stressing. And then just that's it. And then,
what about the stress factor of evolution? Like people are getting all stressed out. Like they gotta make a change. Like it's too crazy here. It's an insane times we're living in. Like, we got crazy leaders.
Yeah. Right?
Like it's foolishness. And people are under mindsets which are enslaving them on a daily basis. Like, we do need patience. I agree, because I don't know what to do about what I see happening. But I see it. I see what's coming down right now. Like, the whole thing it is an abort mission. Whoever put that mission in motion has got to change that direction. So where is will in that? Like, I want to see a change. I'm getting exhausted by going up against all their regulations and not being able to do what's right in this wrong world.
Will patience be with you?
Yeah, it's a job. It's a job to do. So you do have a good message. You have a very clear understanding. You don't use money. You're focused. You keep your peace. Like something's going on there. Is it an answer for the world?
Yes. Well, not in that regard. You don't stop using money to save the world. You stop using money because it's as bad as raping children. It's not about saving the future. It's just about not being horrible.
But they're forced into it. The people are forced to use money.
Not really.
Not like you. You put your life on the line.
I'm not special. That's the problem. I'm just someone who saw the truth and has known the truth for a long time.
But you know what?
But everyone's going to have to stop using money. It's not just one person doing an example and then the rest of the people. It's just hell isn't worth trying to survive in.
And this is hell. This situation that we're in, it is best described as a hellish place.
No, it's literally. This is hell. This is what hell is.
Okay, so then it is our duty to escape.
Well, be patient. Savor patience when it comes.
I remember the Bhagavad Gita, when Arjuna was having his discussion with Krishna.
And he didn't want to go into the war. He says, I got friends on both sides.
And Krishna said, you are not the doer nor the done, which is what you're saying, that there is no free will.
No, but you have to ask yourself, then what is that that's happening if it's not this thing that I think of as choosing? And so that there is still something happening there, but it's not what you think. It's you are life, and this divining process, this operating system in our brain, loves peace and can store information and will use the information to the best of its ability to go towards peace. And that's the nature of life. All life. The fun part is these phenomena called principles, powers, and principalities that we can be wrong. We can think lying can attain peace, but never forgetting that it is ultimately peace that people are going for. Even when they're being horrible, peace is the goal. They're just deluding themselves, thinking that they can be bad together.
Yeah, you have to be rich to be honest. and then they write the laws to maintain their richness and get even more. And really, It's a tough play, man. Like, we're in a tough way.
Not really.
Okay, well, that's enough. This is almost 10 minutes.
This is One Earth Communications, and we're live in Victoria right now.